Well, today I have this old school TV converter, cable converter, basically for those old CRT TVs. You just hook up the cable in the back. You have the antenna in and the antenna out. Basically for those old TVs that don't work with antennas, they required a box. But right there, there's a fuse. I should jump that out and I'll put some salt and some water and we'll see what happens.
All right, we've got that thermal fuse jumped out. I don't even know if it's a thermal fuse, but here we go. Got it jumped out. So now we shouldn't have any interruptions with this. I used a key, as you can see. So hopefully this will be a good show for you guys. Let's see if we can even this out a little better. Just so the salt doesn't all go to one side. There we go. And what should we start with first? So remember the transformer. Oh, we lost our green LED. We got some busyness right there. Oh, we got smoke from the transformer too. It's so shorted out. Look at that. Oh, it's nice salt. Oh man, that smell. Oh man. Oh look, we got corrosion by the transformer. Oh, that arcing there, that's nothing. There goes the transformer. One of them. Good thing I have it hooked up to a GFCI outlet, as you can see. So this is what I was hoping for. I put some salt in this water too, so it makes it a little more conductive. I think you blew that yellow transformer there. Wow, look at that sludge right there. The sludge just building from the side. I thought this would definitely help more of a show. Look at the water right there. I'm surprised it hasn't tripped the breaker or the GFCI. High power, high voltage. Something has to happen soon. Man, just look at the way it's boiling right there where the wires are. Yeah, we blew that transformer there. Looks like. I was hoping for a lot more. I thought maybe some capacitors would have popped or something. Touch that water right now. God. Again, I can't stress this enough. Kids, definitely do not try this at home. I don't recommend anyone trying this at home. You know, but with experience and with just common sense, you know. Come on. I think that's it. I think that's it. It's still sizzling. But yeah, that's it. Still smoking. Yep. Our GFCI is still alive, so that's it. Still smoking a little bit. That's it. That's it. Looks like we fried it. What I'm gonna do, put some of this fuel. Yeah, I think I'll plug it in. We got power to it again. I wanna get my lighter. If anything, I'll trip the GFCI, so I'm not worried. But whoa. Okay. This will get the capacitors to pop. Wow, that burns really good. We'll get the capacitors to pop. They won't pop one way, they'll pop another. Wow, look, the whole housing is just completely melted. Oh, there's one. There's two. There's another one. It's like popcorn or fireworks. Yeah, this actually turned out better than I thought.
Oh, there's another one. So loud too. Jeez, man. Hopefully we'll get that big one there to pop. Once the flames go out, I'll start it up again, more on the other side. I think that's it.
There we go. I'm going to put it out and then I'm going to start it up right here. And we'll put mainly on these ones.
Oh, it's still like, it's so hot.
Lighter. And hopefully the rest of this will pop.
I
got one.
A little tiny one. I don't think they're gonna pop anymore.
Get this one though, the big one to pop. That's like,
come on. Something has to happen here. Yeah, I don't think any more are gonna pop, but I think that's gonna do it.
Yes.
Oh, one more. We got one more pop. I think that's it. All right, well.
Oh, there's one of the capacitors that just shut up.
All right, well, that'll do it for this video. So feel free to like, comment, subscribe, and share. More destruction videos coming up in the future. And we'll see you in the next one.
And if anyone was wondering about the key, this is it. Chemically burned, no longer a shiny chrome key like a screwdriver. So, all right, well, that'll do it for this video. Feel free to like, comment, subscribe, and share. We'll see you in the next one.